Hey, this is Will Putney. I'm a producer at Graphic Nature Audio, and this week I'm here as the guest producer for Converse Rubber Tracks. Here are the five ways bands can be more prepared when they come to the studio to make a record. Number one would be, and this is seems so obvious, but you'd be amazed on every level how bands blow this. Make sure your gear works. Make sure your guitars can be intonated. Make sure your lugs on your drums are not going to fall off after you hit the drum for 5 minutes. If it doesn't work, don't hide it. Just get it fixed before you come, or tell your producer, and then we'll figure something out. The worst thing is when you spend all these hours getting set up and then it's time to track something and you realize that the instrument isn't gonna work. You know, it's a vibe killer in the studio and it slows the process down. The second thing that bands can do to be prepared when they come to the studio to work with a producer is to really know your songs and have as many people in the band know the material as possible. The best process for me and what I feel like is the most productive and creative is when everybody in the band who's going to contribute to the pre-production or the recording process really knows the material, because you can bounce ideas off each other a lot faster and it's a lot easier for people to tweak parts or relearn parts than it is to learn a whole new thing from scratch. You know, the best bands come in and they can all play their songs together as a band and it already sounds cool, and that's a better starting point. So that's something that I would highly recommend. If they're going to work with a producer, they should really sit down and make sure that everyone's on the same page as far as being open-minded to change their music. I've run into this a lot, particularly with younger bands, when they'll get very, very attached to their demos or very attached to the songs or riffs or lyrics that they wrote. And when it's time to get into pre-production and to work on songs, sometimes they seem to be a bit more hesitant to let go of certain things or to make changes because they're kind of overly protective of their music. So I think the best records get made when the best idea wins, and I think that in order to have the most creative, inspired record, everybody really should be open to letting anything happen with their music, not strong-arming a particular part in a song just because it's yours. So having that open mind and making sure your whole band is also on that page is a very good tip to have when you're, you know, before you come into the studio. Everybody in the band should get into the mindset where they're not gonna sweat the small stuff. I see this a lot with bands where they obsess over certain things like the tail of a delay or the decay of this, or very, very fine, fine details, which on artistic level is impressive that you're that dug in and that, you know, paying that much attention to the very tiny details of your music. But having the bigger picture about what the public is gonna hear and take away from the songs, sometimes it's a time waster when you get lost in those teeny, teeny, tiny details instead of sort of focusing the time and putting the strengths and your mind and your mental, you know, your mental power on making the song better, making the energy of this part better, making, you know. So it's a thing I see with more technical bands, and I see it with the artsier bands. And it's definitely slowed down bands in the studio before. It can hinder progress when at the end of the day, you might be the only one who ever even notices that, you know? So although I think those details are very cool, I also think you need to keep in mind, are people ever gonna notice the difference in the thing that we have just spent 2 hours dialing, you know? So that's a pretty cool tip. And for those OCD guys out there, it's something to work on before you go to the studio. The fifth, and this is probably the most important thing that bands need to do to be prepared when they come to the studio: write good songs. Write good songs and write a lot of songs. Write more songs than you probably need to make a record, and then write another song anyway. I think the more material, the good material that a band can have, the more chances they have of getting a good record. Like if you have 15 songs for a 10-song album, we get to cut 5 songs and still have a perfect 10 for 10 record. If you only have 10 songs and we have a 10-track record and one or two of those is bad, we have duds on the record. You know, it's important for singers too. Bands usually come with instrumentals first and then the singer has to take a shot at 10 songs, and if he doesn't nail all 10, then there's some songs with some lyrics that aren't so hot on the record. Whereas if we had 15 songs and he took a shot at all of them, a few of them might not get there, but we still have enough solid material to make a good album. So, I mean, creating the most amount of good material possible. Again, it's something that seems obvious, but not going to the studio and stressing out and struggling to finish up your songs before we start a record. You know, it lets you get to work faster. It lets you be able to let go of stuff that isn't really gonna make it. We don't have to beat up an all right song to try to make it good. We can just lose stuff and keep all the good tunes. No filler, all killer. So for me, that's another, you know, probably the most important one. Make sure your songs are good. And if they're not good, write better songs and then make a record. The world will wait and be much happier that you wrote good music than you rush something out for your audience. That was 5 tips for what you can do to be prepared before you go to the studio. Thanks for listening to me. I'm Will Putney.